Hi, I'm Brandy Saragossa. I'm the Director of Operations for Maui Food Bank, and I've had a long history of volunteering my time through my church. So when the opportunity came to work for the food bank, I really wanted to try that out because it was a nonprofit. They did good for other people. So I signed up to be a driver. And from there, I've learned more about what food banking is and fell in love. And now, 6 years later, here I am. But I think it all starts with trying new things. So that's why there's volunteer opportunities.
Oh, I love that. And so you were actually able to make a career and something that you're passionate about through a volunteer opportunity. That's
Yes.
amazing. That is
Long history
absolutely
of
amazing.
volunteering, and then you find your niche, and then you go with it.
Okay, that has been a similar thing I've experienced. Hawaii has this like special thing about it where like when you invest in the community and you volunteer, like things come, you know what I mean? Like connections come, people come, a vision for your own future comes. It's just fascinating.
Yep. And I truly believe that when you're connected with an organization that has a mission, there's that assignment. It's more than just a job. You're working towards a mission and assignment for your life.
Talk to me about what people need to donate. What do y'all need and what do y'all not need?
Okay. Some of our top items, they are listed on our website, www.mauifoodbank.org. But I'm going to go through the list real quick. Any canned good protein items is a hot item, and we don't get a lot of donated canned goods like Spam, Vienna's, what else? Corned beef. Those are pretty pricey right now. So when we do get them in, they go out of our warehouse really quickly. Canned chilies, canned beef stews, anything that's a meal in a can is really great. Something that people don't know is that we also distribute fresh foods. So produce, frozen items, we take those. We actually distribute over 2.7 million pounds of fresh produce in the last 14 months. So produce has been high on everyone's needs list. Eggs, milk. So if you are donating to our hub here in Wailuku, you can bring those in because we have cold storage for it.
Fantastic. So I was, and the what prompted this is I was reading an article and it said that a lot of people bring in like boxed macaroni and cheese. And the problem with that is a lot of families don't have access to milk, which you need milk to make. So do y'all end up seeing things like that donated here, like things that just aren't needed?
I don't want to say mac and cheese isn't needed because
I'm
it's
sorry, that was a mis that
no.
that's not exactly what I meant, but okay. Yes, go ahead.
But no, we've had situations where they'll donate something, but they don't have the other thing to make it. So that happens a lot. Unfortunately, we are just a supplement. So when we provide things through our purchase dollars, it's those types of items that they can use in many ways, and they don't need extra things to add to it. So we have been providing and purchasing eggs and milk and produce from our local farmers so that families can make complete meals.
Okay, that's amazing. So, would shelf stable things like evaporated milk or cartons of non-dairy milk or milk be good things to donate?
Those are great things to donate, and I wish I remembered to mention that. Thank you. So, shelf stable milk can last a long time and it's still very good. They're tasty. So we buy those too, but when we get them, it offsets the cost. So, shelf stable milk, macaroni, anything in a cup that kids can also make. We're about to come up on the fall break. So some kids will be home. So we have our youth centers coming in for mac and cheese bowls, granola bars, things that are easy for kids to eat, and they don't need an adult to help prepare them.